The Korean smartphone maker might be working on one of the largest tabs ever, the Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra. The Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra might come with a gigantic screen of almost 15 inches. While there is no official confirmation if the brand is working on such a tablet, but a leak has emerged that reveals some of the key specifications of the Tab S8 Ultra. Tipster Ice Universe has revealed the model number, screen size and battery capacity of the device. As per the Tipster Ice Universe, the Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra will have a massive 14.6-inch display with a 3K resolution. While there is no confirmation, one might expect it come too with a Super AMOLED panel. This panel should get 120Hz refresh rate support. The Tipster also claims that the codename of the Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra is SMX906B, which means that we should get more details as soon as it visits any certification or benchmark website. Oppo has finally announced its Color OS 12 software in China. In doing so, the company is the second OEM after Samsung to unveil its Android 12 skin. It previously rolled out an Android 12 beta for the Oppo Find X3 back in May. However, the same wasn't based on Color OS 12. These are the key features. Color OS 12 headlines an all-new new UI language. The company has focused on uncluttering, with more spaced-out page layouts, increased text contrast, and distinguishing color shades. The icons also get a new, softer look. The new operating system also introduces 3D animated images called emoji. They use Oppo's face capture algorithm to let users create their personalized emoji avatars. Emoji can mimic facial movements and expressions in real time, just like Apple's Animoji. Users will be able to customize their images by adjusting parameters like skin color, hair, eyes, nose, accessories, and more. Oppo's is also revamping its smart sidebar, the menu that can be pulled up from the side of the phone for quick access to file transfers, apps, messages, and more. Smart Sidebar 2.0 incorporates 6 new tools. For example, while browsing for a preferred song online, users can open it in the Music Player app. The Smart Sidebar can also now help users compare prices while shopping online. Color OS 12 also brings a new PC Connect feature called Cross-Screen Interconnection. It allows users to operate their phones through their laptops. Additionally, it offers transfer speeds of 45 megabits per second, meaning you can send roughly 500 photos from your phone to your PC in just a minute. The feature supports a majority of laptops from mainstream brands that come installed with Windows 10 or a higher version. Android 12's new privacy features also make it to Color OS 12. This means you'll get permission reminders when third-party apps use your mic, location, and camera. You'll also get access to Android 12's privacy dashboard, allowing you to manage and authorize app permissions. Xiaomi has officially confirmed that the 11 Lite NE 5G will launch on September 29 in India. The company claims that it will be the slimmest and lightest 5G smartphone of 2021. The 11 Lite NE 5G weighs only 158 grams and measures 6.81 millimeters in thickness. Xiaomi also states that the top and side bezels are razor thin at just 1.8 millimeters. The Xiaomi 11 Lite NE 5G specifications are no secret, as the device has been unveiled globally. It comes in 4 different colors: truffle black, bubblegum blue, peach pink, and snowflake white. The Chinese smartphone maker is prepping up for the launch of the Oppo Watch 2 ECG edition in China later today. Ahead of the official launch, the renders of the Oppo Watch 2 ECG edition are revealed by Evan Blass. The newly leaked render showcases us that the Watch 2 ECG edition will feature the same design as that of the Watch 2 standard model, except that it will come with an additional ECG feature. Realme will launch the GT Neo 2 in China on September 22. The device is expected to launch sometime next month in India as well. Ahead of the launch, Realme has confirmed that the GT Neo 2 will feature a diamond ice core cooling system. According to reports, this cooling system packs three-dimensional graphene, customized concave and convex surface covering the heating source. It also includes a stainless steel vapor chamber heat dissipation surface of 4,129 square millimeters, which is an increase of 26% in terms of area. The cooling system also includes a screen warehouse graphite sheet and a ScreenIC graphite copper foil. Samsung Galaxy S22 series is still a few months away from its official launch. Ahead of the official announcement, some key details of the Samsung flagships have leaked. Tipster Ice Universe claims that Samsung's upcoming Galaxy S22 and S22 Plus smartphones will use the newly launched Gen 5 sensor. The 50MP sensor comes with Dual Pixel Pro technology, which is an all-directional autofocusing technology. It is claimed to offer excellent, sharp images in bright or low-lit environments. Regarding the S22 Ultra, the tipster claims that Samsung will introduce 45-watt fast charging support. It is unknown if the other two models will also get the faster charging speed support or come with 25-watt fast charging support instead. Lastly, the tipster shared the details of the upcoming Exynos 2200 SoC. He claims that the SoC will have one Cortex X2 core clocked at 2.9 GHz and three such cores clocked at 2.8 GHz. It will have four efficiency cores clocked at 2.2 GHz. Moreover, the SoC will feature an AMD GPU clocked at 1250 MHz. Ice Universe states that the mentioned performance frequency is only for the S22 Ultra. The clock speed for S22 Plus and S22 will be different, he said. The Realme Narzo 50A smartphone is expected to launch in India soon, and now, ahead of its potential launch, Realme India CMO, Francis Wong, took to Twitter to confirm the chipset that will be used in the upcoming smartphone. In a post, Wong wrote, "We choose MediaTek Helio G85 processor with 1 GHz GPU and HyperEngine enhancements for all young players with our upcoming Realme Narzo 50A. Being an optimized and reliable processor, I'm sure it will offer the young players the best experience." The Vivo X70 series will launch in India on September 30th. The company has teased the launch of the X70 Pro Plus in India alongside the X70 Pro. There is no word on whether the vanilla X70 will launch in India. The event page does not have any mention of the vanilla X70, nor does it reveal the device's design. Reports claim that the base X70 will not debut in India. Vivo is yet to comment on the matter. Yesterday, iQ announced it will unveil the iQ Z5 on September 23rd and confirmed the smartphone will have the Snapdragon 778G SoC at the helm with LPDDR5 RAM and UFS 3.1 storage. Today, the company has revealed some more features of the smartphone. The iQ Z5 screen will have a 120Hz refresh rate like its predecessor, Z3, but iQ doesn't tell us if it's an LCD or an OLED panel. However, the display will have a 240Hz touch sampling rate, DCI-P3 coverage, and HDR10 certification. Additionally, the iQ Z5's audio department will come with some improvements over the Z3 as it will pack stereo speakers for surround sound and support higher resolution audio and higher resolution audio wireless. Apple unveiled its flashy iPhone 13 Pro earlier this week. At the time of unveiling, we reported that the A15 Bionic chip used in the normal iPhone 13 series and the iPhone 13 Pro series is different. The Pro models have an extra GPU core, probably for that 120Hz ProMotion display. Now, MacRumors has spotted the first Geekbench benchmark test of the iPhone 13 Pro, revealing its beast-wide performance. MacRumors says that in terms of GPU performance, the iPhone 13 Pro series boasts a significant performance increase compared to the prior generation iPhone 12 Pro. The iPhone 13 Pro earned a Metal score of 14,216, a 55% increase compared to the 9123 Metal score earned by the iPhone 12 Pro, says MacRumors. Huawei will introduce the Nova 9 series on September 23rd, but two of the phones from the lineup already got listed online. The Nova 9 Pro popped up on Tenna with its model number RTEAL00, with a full specs sheet. The Huawei Nova 9 Pro will have a 6.72-inch screen with a 120Hz screen refresh rate and 300Hz touch sampling rate. The main camera is said to have a 50MP sensor, while the other three snappers will have 8MP, 2MP and 2MP imagers. There will be two 32MP cameras at the front and what is most likely a wide and ultra-wide combo. OnePlus is gearing up for the launch of a new handset in the OnePlus 9 series dubbed as the OnePlus 9RT. The smartphone is rumored to launch on October 15. The specifications of the device were first reported last month by Android Central. The device was spotted on BIS certification by the end of August. The OnePlus 9RT was listed on the certification website with the model number as MT2111. Now, in a recent development, the OnePlus 9RT has gained the required 3C certification in China. The certification reveals the charging capability of the handset and the model number ahead of the official launch. According to the 3C certification, the OnePlus 9RT carries the model number as MT2110. The handset will offer 65-watt fast charging and 5G connectivity support, as per the 3C certification. The past leak suggests that the OnePlus 9RT will be an upgrade over the OnePlus 9 in terms of the camera configuration. The rest of the specifications of the OnePlus 9RT are believed to be the same as the OnePlus 9R. Goodbye passwords, see you never. Microsoft has delivered on its promise to offer passwordless access to its accounts. The new feature will be rolling out in the coming weeks and needs the Microsoft Authenticator app to work. The new passwordless option was announced by Microsoft in a blog post. The post also states that 579 password attacks occur every second, which is 18 billion attacks in a year. Xiaomi has just added two new flagship devices to its T lineup, the Xiaomi 11T and Xiaomi 11T Pro. Both devices pack quite a punch, but the highlight of the new series is Xiaomi's 120-watt hypercharge in the Mi 11T Pro. According to Xiaomi, the whopping 5,000 mAh battery in the Mi 11T Pro can be fully charged in just 17 minutes. Also, it can go from 0 to 72% in 10 minutes. This is much faster than the 120-watt fast charging in Mi 10 Ultra, which takes about 21 minutes to fully charge. The Mi 11T Pro and Mi 11 both come with a 6.67 inches 120Hz AMOLED display. The screen is protected by Corning Gorilla Glass Victus and offers a peak brightness of up to 1000 nits. Under the hood, the Mi 11T Pro is powered by Snapdragon 888 and comes in two memory options, 8GB and 16GB. Meanwhile, the Mi 11T runs on MediaTek Dimensity 1200 and only has 8GB of RAM options. Another difference between the two is that only the Pro variant comes with the 120-watt fast charging. While both offer a 5,000 mAh battery, the Mi 11 comes with 67-watt fast charging. One major highlight of the Mi 11T lineup is the camera. Both Xiaomi devices come with a triple camera setup with a primary 108MP wide lens, an 8MP ultra-wide, and a 5MP lens for macro photography. For selfies, the Mi 11T and Mi 11T Pro comes with a 16MP camera. That's it all for today, guys. See you another day with more tech-related news.
Hasta la vista, baby.